Matthew Dion lived at that house.
He does indeed. News 9 confirmed that he's the son of the couple that owned this house. That couple is in their 70s. They have not been located since yesterday's explosive fire. Dion, as you said, also not located. Now, speculation is swirling among neighbors and family wondering who was killed. Investigators would like to locate and speak with. His name is Matthew Dion, 38 years old, the son of the couple who live in the home that was shaken off its foundation Monday by an explosion. Dion may be driving a white Nissan Altima with New Hampshire plate 341-0587.
He lived in the home, and we have not been able to locate him. So we're concerned to know that he is all right in the first instance, and we need to question him about his knowledge of whatever the events were that transpired at that home.
Dion family members say that Matthew lived in the blue split level with his fiance and her teenage child and his own parents, Bob and Connie Dion, who are listed as the property owners. Investigators haven't named the deceased, but neighbors are buzzing with speculation and worry. Many have known Bob and Connie for years.
I think the buzz is what really happened, you know, because we had seen the family when we were standing by the crime scene, and you know, they didn't even know what was going on. Some said that the family was away, some said the family was there, nobody could get a hold of them. So I think the main thing that most people are saying is what really did happen.
News 9 tracked down a man who says his daughter lived with Matt Dion for years in Atlanta, Georgia. He asked not to be identified, but said when Dion moved back with his parents, he lived upstairs while the elderly couple lived in the basement, the part of the home that is now a focus for fire investigators.
They're still trying to find out how the fire started. And then we know that we have two victims who were found in that home, and we'll have to wait for the medical examiner to confirm their identities and determine their cause of death.
And on that note, it's a unique situation here. We've learned that the bodies are still inside the house here on Mooresville Road. That's sort of the next step that everyone is waiting for the medical examiner to come and remove those bodies, get that autopsy underway and those IDs underway. Much of this case really remains a mystery at this hour. Just want to note here that despite a lot of public speculation, this was not a meth lab inside. You would see a whole different set of crews here if there was a meth lab inside. Also, we're told that crews and police and investigators could be here until tomorrow collecting evidence. We're live in Manchester. Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.